remembering it from last game, right? Vengeance was just optional, so
PTSD,
you have,
man.
PTSD, I agree. You have to ban it out. The Kanja as well coming out, but still, this has been the same ban for the blue side. It's always been first man Fanny all three games.
Blue is the first pick, right? I'm colorblind, so I need to double confirm. So this, okay. Yeah. So yeah, I kind of feel like this is this is the way that they flex. Falcon, I would say, we haven't seen the full draft, but they are in such a good position because Falcon on the second pick, red side is very dangerous because they can pick the Natalia last. If they want, they can go up for the Johnson Kadita, which they kind of like popularized again. And when they bring that up, it's kind of interesting where they swap the roles, where Naomi's going to be the one using the Kadita and Justin's going to be the one driving Johnson.
I mean, again, the man you see on screen is
the villain.
The Japanese villain thinking, the masterminding behind it all. And let's see. It's a Grock fan comes through. Let's see here the response from the side of Incendio. They have the first pick. Oh, it's a quick pick here, and it's going to be 1-1.
The Wanwan that was banned out two times in the last two matches finally open and picked up,
Joy!
But it does leave the Joy open.
We forgot about
for
Joy.
Falcon Esports, and the Joy is so good. Why? Because, okay, obviously, she's super strong. Secondly, hey, flexible. You don't know where this Joy's gonna go. You all right? Technically, fair
she's
miss.
A ballerina.
She is a ballerina.
She's strong, she's flexible,
she is?
And she can dance.
You're right, you're
she
right.
She has beat to it, too.
Make sure you give her a ballerina skin.
Okay.
It needs to happen. It needs to happen.
It's
and
taken.
Advice free
taken.
Idea from LaFell.
I mean, it doesn't have to be free.
I like it.
Just saying. Okay, so looking at the draft right now, it's very quick picks. But now it's slowing down a little bit because Nintendo is like, okay, we got a 1-1. We got a very good laning phase up in the gold lane. And the Estus has been picked up as well as the Frederick. The Frederick is okay, it's cool. But the Estus pick has been shadow buffed as well with the changes of how vision works. Is it enough though?
I think it might here, Mariko. Looking at the three compositions that Incendio picked up, you have an idea. They want to clump up, but take a look
Lolita.
At the response. Lolita, again, a very good counter for that Estus.
Not just for the Estus, but also the Wanwan, right? With the shield that she has, that crossbow attack, and even the first ability is going to have, you know, for sure, looking at it, Incendio's going to have a hard time popping the crossbow attack and even getting some damage, even if he gets the weakness points. So now, you can already see respect ban towards Incendio. Falcon Esports know that Rosa loves picking the Lunox and also the Faramis. So now, with the Faramis picked up, the Lunox ban, they might actually be forcing Incendio to pick up an uncomfortable hero for Rosa.
We gotta talk about the first three picks for both teams. For the side of Falcon, it looks like if they wanna go aggressive, they can, because they have a lot of ways to engage fight with the Faramis as well as the Lolita. And not because we see the Lolita, we see the Faramis, we gotta assume that Joy is gonna be a jungler here. So once she has both buffs, maybe she just can initiate.
Dance around.
Yeah, dance around, like trying to make sure that Incendio can't really move forward, because in terms of how Incendio wants to play, they got good sustainability with both the Frederick as well as the Estus, but we talked about it. If you guys want to clump up, it's kind of advantageous for Falcon.
I think it might actually go to the XP lane instead of the jungle, right? We know that right now, the Vengeance is so good on Joy, and it's either going to be the mid or the XP. I'm leaning more towards XP because Justin's signature is that Faramis. We've seen him make those crazy plays by initiating team fights on that Faramis. So we'll see. Now, again, that's the Yeep ban. They're really starting to nail down on Rosa's hero pool as Incendio look for their final ban. Looking at Falcon, the jungle still open with the gold lane too. Does Incendio want to target that gold lane even more? Or target the jungle?
Again, perhaps maybe banning an assassin might fall through here. Again, realizing that they have a 1-1, so a Ling ban just makes sense.
True.
But no, it's going to be another. They committed to a gold lane ban here in that Leslie, so opening up an assassin to be picked up from side of Falcon. Now, Falcon will not pick up an assassin immediately. They will secure that Irithel, so I guess they are going front to back.
Instantly, think about 1-1, right? Even before the nerfs, She was heavily countered by the Aerithel. The movement that Aerithel has while she's able to basic attack, it is a nightmare for 1-1 to deal with. It's almost impossible to win, right? You really need help early on. They do have that Estes, but still, Aerithel now, especially considering that the 1-1 has been nerfed, where her first ability can no longer stun, but it's just an immobility, Aerithel can punish her even more. So we'll see how this lane plays out. Obviously, you got to count the fact that they have the roamers. They're constantly going to be roaming, rotating across towards the gold lane too. But whoa. Senya Supremacy, the pick of the Pharsa, and a Khalid.
Okay, a very strong lane here within that Khalid. I guess it's a signature. It's a comfortable hero for the EXP for Alien. But I love that Pharsa pick. Why? They need magical burst, and that Pharsa pick just adds more dimensions to it. Yeah, we mentioned about that Ling earlier, and there you go. Ling comes in to the side of Falcon. Now, looking at the 10 heroes,
yeah,
I gotta say, it's quite even hero power-wise.
Yeah, it looks like, Mirka, you got it right. Yellow Flash will be using the Joy. How appropriate, Yellow Flash, Joy. So,
do you
feel good about yourself?
I do, man. Right, called it. Yellow hero, he's Yellow Flash. He got it from Naruto.
Yeah, I like Minato as well.
What about you, Gon?
The Flying Raijin.
I like Naruto.
Joy's a fast character.
It's very fast. I'm like, whenever she moves, I'm like, whoa, that's fast.
That is fast.
That is fast.
You know what? Give me a flash prediction while you're at it for
Falcon.
The match. Okay, Falcon, that
Falcon,
was really
man.
Fast. Gonny, I can't wait for you. Oh, Falcon, okay. Well, I'll give mine, right? I do think Falcon too. Looking at the drafts, they have a solid composition.
They have
that's
Joy.
Really flexible. And Tatatat, yeah, they have Joy too. Incendio Supremacy, however, also have a pretty solid composition, so we'll just have to see the execution from both of the teams as we dive into the Land of Dawn for game and match number 3, best of 1 for Group A.
Let's see, ladies and gentlemen, Falcon and as well as Incendio, it looks like that Khalid will have the execute, so a very aggressive Khalid I expect coming from that EXP lane. We'll have to see. Meanwhile, other than that, it's just 2 Purifies on the board for the side of Incendio Supremacy.
Yeah, right now I'm actually looking at the EXP as well, and Yellow Flash is trading a little bit aggressively here against the Khalid. Has to be careful because, yeah, like you said, the execute is there. So if he catches him slipping, then he can die as fast as Flash.
I'm so sorry.
Like the execution, like
obviously, okay. Right? And you know, the pickoff game here from the Khalid, right? Alien can definitely abduct Yellow Flash in that XP lane, but you can see right now the duel's happening just in towards the XP lane. As Rose is going to be caught, has the Wings by Wings. Good maneuverability to get out of that one. And in the early game, just like you mentioned, Alien's going to have a better time.
You can see here Rose already popped that Purify as well. Gets stunned up. No follow-up damage just yet to take the first blood as Apex is always there. Just in time to give the heal.
Personally, here as an analyst, I kind of want to see how Apex plays with this Estus, because in my head, when you have an Estus, you kind of want to force certain fights, especially you have a Khalid, you have a Pharsa that kind of scales very, very well in the early stage of the game. So I want to see how they're going to control the side lanes and try to actually go for the turtle fights and maybe try to force out mistakes from Falcon.
Well, Yellow Flash the Vengeance still able to get out of the two-man gank there from Rosa and TNZ. Meanwhile, in the gold lane, Ken almost find a kill onto Sunshine, jumps back in to pick up first blood. Falcon Esports strike first, but Yellow Flash is going to fall in that XP lane. Incendio trading really well with the turtle control too.
My god, with Ling down, of course, TNZ will take that first turtle, no problem. So looks like Incendio, they will pick their battles. They will not go for another fight. But now they will manage their lanes better because now they will shift their focus towards the gold lane.
I have a question, right? In this current patch, LaFell, is it more worth to get the gold turret or the turtle?
Personally, for me, I kind of still feel like it's the turtle because the snowball effect of this game is actually very, very strong. So if you can get an extra shield and force it out, it's going to look great. Rosa gets a kill onto Naomi, and TNZ gets one onto Justin. And this is what I want to see. Pick up the pace. Try to put pressure onto Falcon.
Man, Incendio Supremacy here with the Blacklist Evo 2. They're styling really good in the early stage of the game. And Ken, he's still not going to be able to actually look for more towards that gold lane just because there's no mid control. And Zipix, he might be caught here. No sprint, no battle spell. Incendio trying to sandwich him under the tier 1. TMZ jumping in onto Naomi as Apex 47 jumps in as well onto Zipix. Zipix using the ultimate right now, but Sunshine's going to be able to dish out some damage with the Cult Ultra placed. That's the Appraiser's Wrath. And that's Zipix taken down. The killing spree for Rosa, as he's absolutely massive here. Ken finally rotating towards that top lane. Sunshine gonna be targeted by Ken right now, but that's gonna be the damage coming through to pick Justin off. Ooh. Time of the blade popped in. Ken looking for more, dashing in, but it's still the sustainability from Incendio. Not going to be able to get anything on the board for Falcon, and it's Incendio, again, showing the teamfight masterclass.
A great setup, but a sharp execution. Incendio supremacy. What the heck? They managed to take down top lane, and looks like they will get that early snowball. What can they take advantage from this space that they have, LaFell?
Well, like we brought up earlier, right? Like, in terms of draft, yeah, we gave it over to Falcon, but the way that you use the draft, like I said, I want to see how they use this Estus. Try to force out fights, because Falcon, they need some time to scale up. And right now, Incendio, they're using their draft to the best of their abilities. And right now, Falcon, it was beautiful. Naomi tried to catch them, but Tianzi making sure that Naomi can't get multiple hits with the ult.
The Numenon Blast, once again, like you mentioned, LaFell, not really going to be able to connect onto anyone as Yellow Flash just backs off using the ultimate defensively. A big resource spent, two resources spent, two massive ultimates. As Ken is still looking for the steal, jumps in, not gonna be able to find it right now. As Ken's gonna be taken low. TMZ looking for the damage. Is Ken still able to get out of the Raging Sandstorm? But still, it's Incendio picking up that free turtle.
Good attempt, good effort to steal that turtle away, but Incendio still with the clutch retributions as of now. Hit number five here, Zipix is just focusing on farm because he realizes that he is slightly behind on Wanwan, Sunshine here, but let's see. Oh. TNZ still managed to get the gold buff, but as of now, it is 5-1, and it is 1,500 gold lead established.
I'm going to say, for Incendio, we got to keep our eyes on to TNZ as well as Rosa, because TNZ is really controlling every single thing that Falcon wants to do in the front line, and Naomi is not having a good time trying to set up fights just because the way that TNZ is playing, he's really focusing on to Naomi, making sure that Naomi can't do anything to force Incendio into a bad situation, and Rosa has been hitting the skills on point, making sure that you do get the crowd control with your first skill, as well as hitting all of your shots to shut down Falcon very, very quickly. So both these players are really stepping up, going up against Falcon.
I mean, taking all the items, Corrosion Scythe builds, DHS isn't really there for Wanwan, so I guess that power spike for that Wanwan isn't there, but take a look at the fight.
Uh-oh, crossbow tank popped in. Justin to be taken down. Naomi is next, but has the shield. Zipix taunted up. No more follow-up from the side of Incendios. Yellow Flash jumps in, looking for that back line as Ken rotates as well. Rosa still able to maneuver really well. Ken's gonna be stunned up, and Sunshine is gonna be able to push Ken back. The taunt coming in. TNZ now. Yellow Flash, the Vengeance! Still able to get out, but Incendio again are able to out-sustain, outlast, and win out in the team fight.
Hey, in M4, you can see a Farsa juking out the Ling. You don't always get to see that, man.
No.
Usually it's a one-sided match. Rosa here with the Farsa, putting on the dance moves.
3-0-3.
Making Ken really work for it.
Again, and he didn't get it even. So a very good mechanic shown here displayed from Farsa from Rosa. By the airstrike popped here just to zone the members from side of Falcon. But now, this is a critical situation here. The next neutral objective is going to be the Lord. So both teams, they need to be careful what they're going to do the next 2 minutes. Let's see execution-wise.
And you can see actually why Falcon is struggling is because they keep on going for team fights while they are 4,000 gold behind. They're not looking to trade because Incendio are doing a really good job to cover up even the weak side of the map. With Alien being as strong as he is, right now, just take a look at the level difference, right? He's two levels up on Yellow Flash, and Rosa is dealing so much damage out.
I guess this is what we've been hearing in scrims. Incendio is actually doing quite a lot.
A beast.
Zipex right now, he only has half HP. And right now, I like the way that the macro play coming in from Incendio is that they're really applying pressure for both sides of the map. And then eventually, they'll come together in mid, making it so that Falcon doesn't get to dictate what's going to happen. Naomi tries to catch them out, but Rosa stops them. We talked about Lolita countering. Nah, man, there's so many ways to stop the Numinum Blast. And Alien goes in on the Z-Pax.
Three men raising Sandstorm. What? Alien! What a play! Just literally, the XP laners today have been absolutely phenomenal. And Alien says, hey, I am here too.
He came from outer space.
Exactly. Yes. I mean, he did it in M3. He now shows that he is also here to win in M4. Let's take a look at the replay once again, LaFell. What happened?
So in this instant replay, Alien, again, he went up to the sky. Man. He came down, dropped onto tree. And the damage, like I said, Rosa is dealing a lot of damage, but Alien, big props. What an amazing ult. And I kind of feel like Falcon did not expect that at all.
Definitely not.
He must have the Blade of Haptises there. Very, very...
That hurts.
Ugh, yuck. Yuck. The Lord is up now. It seems like with the space that Incendio has created, they will claim the Lord. But oh my god. Bot side, they will have compensation though.
Yeah, it's a drain. It's the XP laner. Not a shutdown though. So again, Alien's been doing so much damage, but he has no kills on the board.
Falcon, on purpose.
On purpose, yeah, because he's the weak side of the map. He wants to play that way for Incendio to get the objectives on the other side. And you can see right now, you're right, Ghani, he does have that Heptaseize, and that just explains how his damage has been this lethal when he goes in for those crazy flanks.
This is actually very good because he's a frontliner. It doesn't really help him that he gets a lot of the kills. Tienzi up front going up against three. Naomi goes down.
What? Oh my goodness. Justin's called Alter completely just melted down. Can still trying to flank, but it's not going to work with Apex 47 just constantly there in the back line providing the support. Sunshine is a level up. Now two levels up onto Zipex, who's on a counter towards the 1-1. There's a Cult Altar, there is a shield from the Lolita, and there's an Irithel, yet Sunshine is still shining.
Now you can really see the value of that 1-1. Take a look at the Feather Airstrike. Nice! Hitting Zipex, and he needs to back off. Vacer number one will fall as well. Now Falcon is on full, is in full defense. Incendio, they are disciplining. They see no objectives on the board, they back off. Now, the thing that I want to point out is now you can see the value of that 1-1. It was first pick, and take a look at the stat. 1-1-3 late game. He's untouchable as of now.
Feather Airstrike popped in. Can't leave the damage onto that back line right now, but will not be able to find it just yet. That's going to be Justin taken out, out of nowhere. Ken, looking for the Divine Blaze, not dealing enough. The sustain is too much. When you thought you've dealt with the Estes, Alien just heals back up. Zipix now trying to kite back with Yellow Flash. The Mini Waves comes crashing down onto the base. Ken, looking for the damage. Feather Airstrike stunning him up, poking him down. Again, it looks like Incendio wants to look for an end right now, but with the Minion Waves here, we'll see how they do it. Sunshine still looking for the weakness points, deciding to finally back off, and Falcon have some room to play with again. But Incendio, 8,000 gold lead, building up to a 9K gold lead. Is this even comebackable?
It is honestly comebackable, but not by Falcon outplaying Incendio. Incendio has to make a mistake themselves, because that was one of the better engages Falcon can get. Can go straight on to Rosa, but even in that kind of situation, it looks like not enough damage, or even if he does have enough damage, everyone else from Incendio can see that Ken is there, so go after Ken. It makes it so that he wants to do his job, but everyone is trying to stop him.
Exactly, and that is the case, LaFell. And oh my god, you're right, Mirko, as well. They're banking on Incendio to make a mistake. 10 seconds in, Barca.
Oh my god, he got the healing down, the Estes there.
In time!
Absolutely phenomenal.
Insane.
Again, you could see it. Rosa was caught, but Apex 47. That's why he's an Apex. That's why he's always there. He knows when his teammates need him. And right now, because Ken is low, because he's used that Tempest of Blaze, Falcon Esports have no way to try to contest this. Yellow Flash still trying to force it as he dashes in, back and forth in the jungle. Liver to ultimate right now, dealing out a whole lot of damage with Vengeance popped in. Sunshine not able to find the weakness points as Zipix deals out the damage front to back currently. Justin to be silenced, gonna be taken down, but Lumina Blast not connecting on anyone. Romina Alien can execute Naomi. It's a 2-0. Zipix now to target, and it's a double for Sunshine. It's an absolute disaster for Falcon Esports, but Ken saves the day, clearing out the most of the minions in the mid lane. Yellow Flash gonna have to deal more. Justin flickering out the safety from that Feather Airstrike as Alien just tries to run him down, and Justin will fall.
The team from Turkey will not back down. They are now angry after the first match loss, and it seems like Falcon is the casualty. Lord is up quite freely here as Ling will not be able to do anything in the Land of Dawn now, and it is going to be free Lord. LaFell, the base squad exposed. Can they end the game?
Well, right now they are looking at Ken, hoping that he can't clear all the ways, but now with no energy, Alien goes in. Ken tries to run away. That was just an enhanced basic attack. Ken going up against Rosa, going against Sunshine.
It's a manhunt.
And right now it looks like he is able to survive because Insania's like, nah, we got the Lord. We're going to end this right now. This could possibly be the final skirmish where Incendio could end this game with a 10k gold lead.
13-2! It's not a close game so far. Incendio have been completely dominating. And Zipix, with one feathered airstrike shot, loses almost of his HP. With the Lord marching in still, it's gonna be Falcon Esports over the defense. Space gonna be targeted down by Sunshine as that's gonna be the damage coming through to the Zipix. And it's an upset here with the crossbow tank. The mini wave is still there. Incendio supremacy. Take Falcon Esports down.
The team from Turkey strikes back, equalizing here in Group A. And my goodness, what a thriller match. Unfortunately for the team from Myanmar, they have to take the learn.
I mean, congratulations to Incendio, yeah.
Congratulations indeed.
Here's the thing, right? Caster Curse might be too much. All three of us hit Falcon.
You said Incendio, huh?
I did vote for Incendio, but you asked for Drab, and I was like, oh yeah, Falcon. This kind of does show 6 total IQ. What do we know, right?
What do we know? What does everyone know, right? Falcon Esports coming into this tournament, again, they were the dark horse for MSC.
True.
They were looking as one of the favorites. They were looking to be one of the favorites. We kept on asking, who's the dark horse? Who's the dark horse?
Right now,
Incendio, dude,
here's the thing, right? We got to readjust our power rankings, because look at Blacklist going up against Incendio. Close match.
We saw glimpses, right? We saw glimpses against Blacklist and against this team. Boy, they executed to perfection. What was the score? 15-2, perhaps?
This is the first day.
This is the first day, and we're already getting an upset, right? They were close to upsetting Blacklist, and yeah, you're right. It was 15-2. It wasn't close. It was not close in game number three. I am still, quite honestly, speechless, but now we're going to get, again, Ophel, to dissect the item build and to dissect this game. Incendio, how do they do it?
Mikasa Mirko, we're going to look at the draft first before we look at the items, because I kind of feel like the draft really dictates what you want to do in the game. I brought it up in the first minutes of the game, right? I want to see how Estus is utilized. And the way that they use it is they're trying to force fights, especially around the EXP lane. And I kind of feel like Falcon, either they misunderstood their own damage, or they just didn't respect Incendio, because they try to keep on fighting. And again, we got to give a big highlight towards Rosa as well as TNZ, because the only way that they lose, if like three members get caught in Numinum Blast. Where's the Numinum Blast? The effort was there. Mm-hmm. Get canceled by the Fredrin. Get canceled by the Farsa. And if the opportunity presents itself, even Alien can cancel it, right? So
even Sunshine.
Not anymore, because it's just immobilized. Yeah. It's no longer stand. But still, we didn't expect this. We thought, okay, everyone's gonna clump up. We're gonna stun. But like, no, you take too long to set up. I don't need that long to set up. I can just interrupt you. Yeah. That was an amazing way to handle this Lolita.
You're right. I mean, a shaky performance overall by the five members from Side of Falcon, but a better execution from the side of Incendio. Now, I'm curious to see the stats here, the numbers. Is it a landslide like the total kills? We'll see.
Well, LaFell, let's take a look at it here. And man, even the sandbag. Incendio are taking everything. Rich Guy, Carry, Sandbag, Forgotten One. And they're all, you know, they're actually spreading it out pretty well.
Four members, different.
This just shows that everyone brought in word. Like everyone has their own responsibility. They executed. I don't want to say it's so different what they did against Blacklist, but like I said, maybe it is the nervous factor where it's like, okay, we got one game in. Now we're feeling good. Now we're feeling warmed up.
Yeah.
They didn't miss a beat. This is our strength. Fight now.
It seems like the
fight
coach,
again.
Exactly.
Fight again.
Fight, fight, fight. And the coach's vision is managed to be implemented by the players as well with the draft that they executed. It's a perfect game. Let's see who's take the MVP.
Yeah.
Estes?
Right. I don't know, man, but
Apex?
Let's introduce our most valuable player,
Rosa
coming in 4-0-8, 682 gold per minute. But in my opinion, mid laners, the goal is not important. It's how you move the map.
Oh,
it's how much damage
you
put down. And my God, Rosa put in a lot of damage.
So much, man. I mean, this was why I actually said Falcon might have the better draft. Rosa was on a Farsa. You're up against a Ling. You're up against a Lolita.
Irithel.
So Irithel as well. And again, there's just so much dive. I mean, to add on to that, you were up against a Joy. There's so much that can actually jump into that back line to threaten you. But Rosa,
you know what's even crazier?
Okay.
You know what's even crazier? Farsa did all that with her eyes closed.
Oh.
You're right.
Lore appropriate. There you go.
Yeah. Technically,
Rosa
right.
didn't do it with his eyes closed, but Farsa
did it. Yeah, but again, that feather airstrike is just unstoppable for the side of somehow Falcon to do anything. So let's take a look at the highlights here. What did Rosa do in particular to get MVP?
I want you guys to pay attention about how Falcon tries to force the fight back and Incendio just take it in stride, because look at TNZ, look at Rosa in terms of the positioning. TNZ is always close around 3 to 4 people, and Rosa is always like 1 or 2 clicks away from the opponent team. And even if get dove on, using the walls especially to kind of like dive in and out to avoid damage, and Alien, a perfect opportunity, and he did not disappoint. Getting 3 people, getting a kill. Incendio, they just take a small snowball, and then they just ran with it.
That was every single time. Naomi didn't get a single good ultimate, because again, it's either Incendio were able to maneuver out of the Numenom blast, or they cancel it straight out. This was a stomp. This was a stomp by Incendio, and it's all props to them, man. They have learned. They really learned from game number one up against Blacklist. I guess right now we can call him the Dark Horse.
Right now, I think it's a good opportunity for us to look at the camera and be like, shout outs to Turkey, man.
Shout outs to Turkey.
Shout outs to Turkey. My goodness, that was
I want to see more.
I do.
I want to see more from Incendio now.
Now you can't wait.
Oh. Now you're impatient.
Don't see that.
But in all honesty, right now you really want to see the best of three, right?
Yeah.
This is still a best of one. Fortunately, we're not going to see Incendio Supremacy up against Falcon again. Maybe later on in the knockout stage. But Falcon now, they're going to have to climb up.
I kind of feel like this might be a wake-up call for them. It's like,
whoa.
The level of competition, man. Yeah, like, because again, like the latest one, MSE, they stomped.
They stomped.
Yeah. And then now in M4, this is the very first game, and they're like, whoa. Okay, we got to take a step back. Like, the teams are scary right now.
Remember, they have Joy, who is very prio in this current patch.
Yeah.
But then again, they do go up against
Joy. Joy didn't have a happy time.
No.
0% team fight presence.
No Joy. Irrelevance. Mm-hmm. Irrelevance in that game. But let's see what match we have next.
What match do we have next? That's a solid question, Ghani, because we are about to reveal it to all of you guys waiting at home. After 3 bangers of a match, we are going to get Todok versus Malvino's game. Oh, my God.
Oh.
LaFell, you can't see it because it's a close-up to me, but LaFell's shaking, man. LaFell's banging on the table and everything. So let's see. LaFell, what's your reaction to the next match?
There.
He's been doing that while it was a close-up to me.
I can't wait, man, because
I wonder who he's rooting for.
I'm unsure.
Maybe the Peruvians?